This is the 14-inch MacBook Pro with the M3 Pro chip. I've had this laptop for almost 250 days now, and I've been using it as the main laptop for most of my work, from video editing while on the road to using it in a docked setup at home. Hey friends, Andrew here, hope you're well. So now 250 days later, here is my long-term review of the MacBook M3 Pro, going over how its battery life has been holding up, some unfortunate thermal issues, some software updates, and why overall I think that this is actually a laptop that's aging really well and is still a great buy. Okay, so firstly, this is the configuration that I've been working with. This has the M3 Pro chip with 12-core CPU, 18-core GPU, 18 gigabytes memory, and 1 terabyte SSD. And everything is holding up really nicely with daily use. The keyboard on the MacBook Pro is still enjoyable to type on. The key depth is fantastic. The actuation is satisfying. The keys are the perfect size for typing accuracy, and Touch ID is still very convenient. The 14-inch display remains sharp, powerful for creative use, and plenty bright at 600 nits and peaks at 1600 nits for HDR content. But I believe something that I've noticed is there's a very small decrease in color gamut coverage compared to the M1 and M2 MacBook Pros, which means it's not as color accurate. But don't worry, it's not that noticeable day to day. For most users, it won't even matter. But if you're a photographer or a professional color grader, it is something to keep in mind. As for the storage, 1 terabyte has been plenty. I don't really store large files locally. I mainly just store stuff like PDFs, Excel docs, and larger files are in the cloud or on the NAS. So 1 terabyte locally has been plenty. You can always buy an external hard drive or cloud storage. The space black color here is also holding up really well, despite me not babying it at all. I've come to actually like the color more and more, to the point that it has probably become my favorite MacBook color, full stop. I complained about the color in my initial review, and I said that I would have liked to see it darker, but after daily use, I actually appreciate that it isn't pitch black. It's this beautiful dark gray with tints of black under certain lights. It also resists fingerprints pretty well, and there's zero scratches so far. And like I said, I haven't been babying this laptop. I've been taking it out and about basically everywhere. And yeah, it's been holding up really well. Then there is the battery life, which has been a highlight feature of the M3 Pro so far. Apple claimed 30 hours on a single charge during the launch of this laptop. And you know what? Even though I'm not always hitting that range, it does come quite close day to day. So this has been a reliable laptop when I'm video editing on the go and need a full day use without a charger. It's a huge perk for professionals on the go. One thing that I have noticed is the battery life drains faster than average when I'm playing music through the speakers and also rendering multiple large video files. Outside of those two things though, it'll last the entire day, no problem, running all sorts of applications and watching YouTube videos. A big part of the very lengthy battery life is that new 3 nanometer chip size. And long story short, that 3 nanometer process has design improvements that optimize how the chip utilizes power. So that all means longer battery life and a cooler operation under heavy load. I have unfortunately run into, of course, the thermal throttling issues on this 14-inch MacBook M3 Pro. So when I edit 4K MXF formats, for example, off my Sony FX6 on a very large video timeline, let's say 20-minute timeline, it starts to overheat over that sustained heavy load. So what happens then, the chip then downclocks its speed to avoid overheating. And then this means throttled performance and a slower experience video editing. I think for like 99% of people, this isn't going to be a problem, but it is a consideration if you constantly push this laptop to its limits. And if that is you, or you think that might be you, you might want to consider the 16-inch model, because its larger size will help handle the increased temperature under load and avoid being throttled. Also, pro tip, use an app called Al Dente, which will cap the charge at 80% to help preserve the battery and get you more charging cycles out of your new MacBook. Still, one of my favorite ways to use this laptop is in its clamshell mode because it uses the GPU to power the external display and creates just a more ergonomic work setup. So throwing it into clamshell mode in a stand and plugging it into a Thunderbolt monitor like the studio display here, the M3 Pro chip is plenty powerful to fill an intense workflow, and with a dedicated keyboard and mouse, it works as well as an iMac or Mac Mini. I've partnered with Logitech on this segment to show you some of my favorite Logitech accessories that go perfectly with a MacBook in this dock setup. So my go-to keyboard and mouse combo is still the Logitech MX Keys S with the MX Master 3S. These are both one of the best keyboard and mouse combos available, and in the new Logitech MX Keys S combo for Mac set, it comes bundled with a pretty comfortable wrist rest. So aesthetically, the set is designed for Macs with its Mac key layout, smart backlit keys that illuminate when I'm about to type, and the space gray finish pairs up perfectly with the MacBook M3 Pro that I have. But more importantly, they're just really high quality accessories. If you've used the MX Master 3S, you'll know that this is one of the best mice on the market with its precise pixel tracking up to 8000 DPI and comfortable design with plenty of shortcut buttons for efficiency. The keyboard has never stuttered, and the low profile switches are just as pleasant to use as the MacBook's keyboard itself. Plus, I'm able to connect them to three Apple devices at once for fast switching when I'm working at my desk. The new MX Brio webcam also graces the Apple Pro XDR display since it doesn't have an inbuilt webcam, and the webcam comes in clutch for professional looking 4K video meetings, so altogether, it's an aesthetic match made for Mac productivity. If you'd like to grab the MX Keys S combo set for your own Mac setup, check out the link and discounts in the description box below. So over the last 6 or so months now, I've noticed improved performance and efficiency with the M3 Pro, and this is because developers have fine-tuned software to unlock more out of the M3 chipset. For example, Adobe, Blackmagic Design, and Final Cut Pro have all released updates optimizing performance for the new chipset for faster rendering times, smoother workflows, and also improved efficiency too. It's the same thing we've seen during the change from Intel processors to Apple Silicon. As more developers updated software and apps for the M1 chip, we saw bigger and bigger performance bumps. So it's great to see that the M3 Pro gets even better with time. And even if you choose to buy an M3 Pro later down the track, when, for example, you know, the M4 or maybe even M5 are out, you'll still likely benefit from ongoing software optimization for an even bigger range of apps. So there's definitely like an element of future-proofed purchase here. I did think to myself though, do I regret not buying the M3 Max? Because you may remember in my initial review, I said that Apple seems to be pushing users towards the M3 Max chip this year. It comes with more cores, a wider memory bus, and is obviously aimed at professionals in video editing, 3D animation, or coding. But as someone who uses Figma, Blender, and edits 4K files, the M3 Pro has been enough in my experience, and at a more manageable price point too. To me, it's like the Goldilocks zone. The M3 Max is super expensive, and the return on those dollars just sort of tapers off. But the base M3 doesn't have enough long-term juice, and don't get me started on the minimum base 8 GB of RAM in 2024. Yeah, it shouldn't be the case. But the M3 Pro sits right in the middle of those offerings and will suit most people's needs. Let's not forget the elephant in the room though, the upcoming macOS Sequoia and Apple Intelligence updates. They're going to be a big part of maximizing the M3 chip performance and future-proofing it too. I think there's a few ways the new macOS will improve the MacBook M3 Pro. So firstly, macOS Sequoia is likely going to optimize power management, which could mean an even longer battery life on the already great M3 Pro. Developers also have the opportunity to optimize their software even further on the M3 Pro architecture. There's also an improved metal framework, which is Apple's graphics framework, that could help juice more graphics processing power from the M3 Pro for gamers and creatives. Plus, there's even rumored improved ProRes acceleration, which means even faster encoding and decoding times for video editors. So That's a lot of new upcoming benefits that will improve the MacBook M3 Pro over time. And that's not even including all the upcoming Apple Intelligence stuff that could speed up workflows by automating tasks. Obviously, this is not unique to the M3 Pro, but the M3 Pro is positioned to take the most capability out of the new OS. The MacBook M3 Pro is also, of course, still a premium device with a price tag that doesn't suit casual users, but it's a decent investment, I think, knowing that the M3 chipset is positioned to benefit from the new OS for some time to come. Okay, so after 250 days of using this laptop, I think that the person that's going to benefit most from the MacBook M3 Pro is someone that's still either using an Intel-based Mac or an older Windows laptop, and you're invested into demanding creative applications and you're looking to invest in a future-proof laptop, I think the M3 Pro is a great bet. It's a laptop that's actually sort of hard to fault, and unless you're going to be working on the most intense workflows like large 3D renders, the M3 Pro will probably get the job done. It's a laptop that I think you'd be able to get a solid 5 to 10 years of use out of without any issues, as long as Apple keeps to its promise of 6 or so years of OS updates. But if you have the previous gen M2 Pro or even the MacBook M2 or M3 Air, the performance gains probably don't justify the upgrade cost. My overall thought here is that the M3 Pro is still a really, really strong contender in the laptop market and will be for a while. The blend of power, efficiency, design, ergonomics, and that super long battery life just makes it a pretty safe buy for most professionals who push their laptops. And if you ever find one on sale, I'd say go for it. It's a really safe bet and a great buy. So if you made it to the very end of this video, comment the code word Sequoia and I'll give it a like for watching until the end. And if you have the MacBook M3 Pro or Macs yourself, have you been enjoying the laptop? Let me know. If you do have a MacBook, I'll drop a video right here to my favorite free Mac apps you probably haven't heard of. So go check it out. And as always, thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next video.